23rd, 2010. Happy birthday, Mom. Wish you were here to celebrate. Tears sting my eyes as I slide to the floor. I recognize a folded piece of paper peeking out of the overturned journal, and I pull out the soft note to read the words that I have memorized.
February 23rd, 2009. Amelie, I just wanted to say thank you for your gift. I'm so excited. I've wanted to do yoga for ages. This is perfect. I love yoga because of all of its health benefits, but also because it's so calming. I believe this gift will be key to the improvement of my overall health.
If only.
Thank you so much for thinking of me and for giving me such a useful and meaningful gift. I hope we can share this experience together someday soon. You are my fly girl. Love always, Mom.
I shiver as I realize we were never able to go. The cancer had come too fast, too strong. We weren't given any time, and now time seems to be running out as my memories of her begin to blend and fade. I remember when my mother used to read. I remember when I came home crying because I was the smallest in my grade, and she wrote me Walter Smiles to show me that it is always best to be yourself, no matter who that may be.
This is Walter the giraffe. Walter has yellow skin with brown spots. He has big brown eyes and a big red smile. But most of all, Walter is tall, very tall. So tall that his tie stretches farther than you and me. So tall, in fact, that he's taller than the tallest tree. One day, Walter and his friends were playing hide and seek. But Walter couldn't find anywhere to hide. He hid behind the haystack. Too tall. Humph, said Walter. I wish I were as small as mouse. He hid behind the doghouse. Too tall. Humph, said Walter. I wish I were as little as dog. He hid behind the wishing well. Too tall. Humph, said Walter. I wish I were as tiny as frog. He hid among the tall grasses. Too tall. Humph, said Walter. I wish I were as mini as ant. Finally, Walter hid behind a tree. Still too tall. Oh dear, cried Walter. All I want to do is play with my friends, but my neck is much too long. He walked over to his favorite leaf patch and started munching on his snack, waiting for his friends to come play I Spy. Suddenly, Walter heard a commotion. He hurried back to see what was going on. Oh no! It was Calvin the cat! He was stuck in a tree! Calvin was scared of heights, but he had climbed to the top of the highest tree. It was a very good hiding place. But now he couldn't get down. All the animals gathered and tried to figure out how to get Calvin back down to the ground. They thought, and they thought, and they thought, but no one could reach that high. Unless... Walter's eyes lit up. I can help you! Walter walked over to the tree and stretched his neck up, 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 as high as he could reach. Here, Calvin, climb onto my neck, he said. Then you can slide down to the ground. Calvin reached out one hand and then the other. He gulped. He stretched out his left foot and then his right. Then slowly he slid down, 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 down Walter's neck, and then hopped off onto the ground. Hooray for Walter! The animals cheered. Walter stretched his neck up, 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 as high as he could reach, and he smiled.
I smile as I remember the sound of her soft voice as she read me the poem that she kept by her bed about Amelia Earhart, her idol.
I am a woman. I am tied in gowns, in marriage, to the ground, or so I should be. But I am a fly girl. I am free to roam in time, in space, the wild blue yonder, as it should be. For I am a fly girl. I have strength, spirit, daring.
I am the wind and the stars.
I remember how she always told me that I could do anything, be anything. I remember how she used to sing and how she used to conduct so beautifully, like the singer's voices were paint and she was Monet. I remember all of this as I write Regisoro. Excited chatter buzzes like bees as we change into our formal dresses, and there is an abundance of butterflies in my stomach. We wait in our line on the stairs while the MC introduces the concert. I am totally unaware of my surroundings. All I can think is, what if nobody likes it? I shiver as a cool hand on my shoulder brings me back to reality. Relax, they're going to love it. I try to smile as the line moves forward. Here we go. I feel 5 years old again as I wander on stage in a bubble, zooming in on the packed pews. Probably 200 people fill the church. Good, I guess. We sold out. My eyes meander back to the director as we start our first piece, and I direct my focus on her. It's just us girls. There's Jackie, and somewhere to my right, Laura's at the piano. But there's no one else to worry about. It's just us girls. Just us. I repeat this to myself through the next 5 pieces, and then I see Jackie catch my eye. It's time. Her hands lift up into the air, and I breathe as one with the choir. Together we breathe, and we sing, and we tell a story. Together we're curious and happy and in awe. Together we sing, and together I'm not alone. The butterflies have gone. I listen to the sound changing color with the lights. I watch it echo around the columns. I feel it soaring out over the audience, and I hear, I would now ask the composer to step forward. It suddenly feels very, very cold, and yet I am also under the impression that I am standing neck deep in a pool of molten lava. It's just us. I think about that night when I first learned what it really is to imagine and create new art. It's just us. I think about that night when I lay in bed and listen to my father playing piano for the first time in months. It's just us. I think about that same night when I wrote the words and the music of this piece, and then I think about tonight and here and now. Then I take a step forward, and with rosy cheeks and sparkly eyes, I take a bow. Thank you.